Hi there, and welcome to What Is It Wednesday? Today's question covers section D08 of the 4th edition task list and G9 of the 5th edition task list. And today's question is, in this type of DTT trial, the trainer inserts already mastered distractors between the targeted SDs. And the answer is expanded trial. Let's touch on the main bullet points of DTT. So first of all, it was brought to us by Ivor Lovaas in the 70s. It is described as a structured tabletop procedure during which skills are broken down into small units and taught to mastery criteria. A response in a discrete trial is controlled by a restricted opportunity. That opportunity is the presentation of the SD, the opportunity to emit the response in the presence of that SD. That's why we use percentage measures in DTT. It's called a discrete trial because each trial has a clear beginning, SD, a clear middle, the behavior or the response, and a clear end, the consequence. This is an empirically validated procedure in the treatment of ASD. Now, what our question today talked about were the types of trials in DTT, and there are four types. The first is a mass trial. This is where we present the same SD for novel material repeatedly with no other distractors. Then we have our block trial. This is where we present a block, which would be like several presentations of one SD, followed by a block, several presentations of another SD. Number three is the expanded trial. That's the answer to our question today. And this is where, as I've said already, we insert already mastered distractors between the SDs that are being targeted. And four, random rotation. And this is where we present any already mastered SDs randomly. In random rotation. There is a lot more to DTT, so do make sure that you read up on it, and I hope this is a good start. I hope that all helps, and I'll see you guys next time.